you guys, welcome back to my channel. For those of you that are new, my name is Alex. I make new videos every week, so make sure to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. So you could probably tell by the title, today we're going to be talking about my experience with the Juvederm collection of fillers. So I actually went and looked back at my photos and my videos and stuff. I've been getting lip filler now for about 6 years, and I've talked about it here and there, but I've never sat down and done a full video just chatting about my experience, what I look for, what to expect. So over the years, I've been able to speak with my specialist to achieve the results that I want for my lips. She also chats with me about possible side effects, just so I always have the latest information about what's going on and what I can expect with my treatment. And of course, we always go over any potential risks. We have a full consultation. I actually did a post back on Instagram when I got my lips done, so if you want to check that out, you can. Of course, we always discuss potential risks and we do a full consultation. She lets me know how long each filler is supposed to last, things like that. So we're going to go over everything in today's video. Like I said, if you're new, please make sure to subscribe. I hope that you learn a lot from this video. Let me know down below in the comments if you have any questions. Also, a big shout out to Juvederm for sponsoring today's video. Make sure to stay to the end for all of the important safety information. Let's go ahead and get started. Before you actually go into your appointment, you want to consider the areas of your face where you may or may not want filler. So for me, 6 years ago, when I first started getting treatment done, I just wanted my lips done. I was younger at the time, obviously, and I just wanted some subtle volume in my lips. I don't want anything like overdone. I just wanted some subtle volume, something that still looked very natural, but gave a little bit more of a pout. I love the way that those bigger lips look, and like lip gloss and makeup, which I was super into at the time, and I still am. So some very subtle volume, and that's what I expressed to my provider, and we would do a consultation, kind of go over that. So she would share with me what she thought, I would kind of share what I was thinking, and we'd come up with a treatment plan. So that's what I did for the first few years of getting treatment done. I noticed that I had some volume loss in my face. I think that was just due to getting older. So I specifically noticed it in my cheeks. So you can actually see, I'll insert some clips from when I went last time to kind of get more volume in those areas that I feel like I've lost it. So in my opinion, the consultation is one of the most important parts, and you just really want to find a provider that you click with and that you think has the same goals as you, wants the same outcome as you, and you kind of make sure you're on the same page. So I will actually drop a link down below in the description box. That way you can find a licensed Juvederm provider near you, and you don't have to worry about scrolling the internet for hours. I'll leave that link down below. Step two, this is super important. When you go into that consultation, you obviously want to chat about the goals that you want, the overall look, the outcome that you want with your appointment, but you also want to make sure that you're asking any questions that you have about side effects, potential risks. So don't be afraid to ask all those questions to make sure that you and your provider are on the same page and that you know exactly what to expect before, during, and after your appointment. So according to a provider survey that was done in July, the Juvederm collection of fillers is actually the number one collection of fillers chosen by providers. So that's really good to know too. Then comes the numbing part, which you may do or may not do. This is typically up to the provider and what they think is best for you. And they'll also be the ones selecting what product they think is best for you. So I have done numbing many times in the past, but this last time that I went, I actually did not do any numbing. And to be honest, I was really surprised when my doctor, Dr. Weisman, said he wasn't gonna do numbing. I was like, I don't know about that, but I was pleasantly surprised. So for example, I got the Juvederm Ultra XC, and the XC at the end of that name actually is for the lidocaine that's in the products. And also I wanna talk about time. So honestly, I find that the consultation is what takes the most time, and just kind of chatting, getting to know your provider and stuff. Then when you go ahead and get started, the treatment, it really depends on obviously what you're getting done and all that, but I find that it's relatively quick. So now I'm actually gonna bring you with me to my appointment, the fun part of the video. So we're actually gonna go back to Nashville. I flew to Nashville for this appointment. I've been going to Dr. Weisman and seeing Molly or him at his office for a while now. And also keep watching so you can hear that important safety information as well. We'll be right back. so you guys got to see my appointment. You saw the actual appointment, but now what comes after? So this is something that your provider is also going to discuss with you too. So activities to avoid or what to do following your treatment. So you might see some side effects like some bruising or some swelling. That's usually what I notice, but the overall side effects that I've experienced are minimal, but obviously everyone's different. So I just want to make sure you guys do know, expect some swelling or bruising. It would last about 4 weeks or less. Next up, I want to chat with you about how long fillers last. I feel like this is a big misconception. I actually have it written down here because I want to get this right. You would not believe the amount of times I get messages of people thinking I'm getting my lips done like once a month or something, and that is definitely not the case. So for me personally, I'm gonna go ahead and read this to you. So for my lips, I have the Juvederm Ultra XC, which I will leave down below. That can last for up to a year, and that's what I've noticed works out for me. So I typically get this done just once a year, and that works out perfectly for me. And then the Juvederm Voluma XC, that's what I have in my cheeks, my chin. And the chin, it can last up to a year, and 2 years in the cheeks. So this is definitely not a treatment that you need to be going in frequently multiple times a year for or anything like that. All right, so I think those answered the big questions. Like I said, just make sure you find a provider that you can trust. Make sure you have all your questions ready for your consultation. Make sure you have that goal in mind, that idea that you're going for, so you can discuss a treatment plan together. So kind of putting together what you want versus what they think would be good for you, and you should be able to come up with a great plan. I will have that link down below so you guys can find a licensed Juvederm provider in your area. And then when you're going through your appointment, don't feel afraid to ever ask any questions, talk about any concerns you have. Just make sure that you are being open and honest with your provider about all of your questions that you want answered. Like I said, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. I'd love to hear from you guys. And I think that's everything I have to say about my experience with Juvederm. Big shout out to Juvederm for sponsoring today's video. I will go ahead and roll all the safety information here, so make sure to check that out.
Not for people with severe allergic reactions, allergies to lidocaine, or the proteins used in Juvederm. Common side effects include injection site redness, swelling, pain, tenderness, firmness, lumps, bumps, bruising, discoloration, or itching. There's a risk of unintentional injection into a blood vessel, which can cause vision abnormalities, blindness, stroke, temporary scabs, or scarring. Talk to a licensed specialist to find out if it's right for you. For important safety information and to find a licensed specialist, visit Juvederm.com.